Dr. Rebecca Tyson is an associate professor in the Irving K. Barber School here at UBC's Okanagan campus. She calls herself a mathematical biologist and says that you can often predict the future by using mathematical models. I asked her how this theory works in her research.
In the models I build, I start with a description about the situation that I'm interested in, the organism that I'm interested in, the process that I'm interested in, at a local level. So I know that organism A eats organism B, or that if organism Y is moving around, it'll move in a certain way in response to its neighbors in the landscape. I can take that local information that I know right now, I can measure things right now, and then I can describe that mathematically. So for example, if I know that something moves randomly, I know how to write that mathematically. Or if I know that an organism moves randomly, but it moves faster when it's got lots of neighbors and it's not very comfortable, and it moves more slowly when it's got more room, then I know how to write that mathematically. So I can take that local information, I can build a model, and then iterate it forward in time and see where it goes. And then I'm predicting the future. So we talk about it as population dynamics. So dynamics, the dynamics of a system is how it evolves in time. And then if I'm looking at space as well, I'm asking how does the population evolve in space and time? And the numbers can go up and down. We can see some things go extinct. We can see new ones come in. We can see them move from one area to another. And predicting this without models can be quite difficult. It's really heavily used in fisheries because you can't see all the fish. You've got no chance. However, when you build a model, I can count everything in my model. If I've got enough local information and maybe enough of this photographic, other measurement information to parameterize my model, I can then not only predict or verify what would happen in the situation that we know of, but I can say, okay, suppose we put a clear cut here, what's that going to do? Suppose climate change comes along, what's that going to do? I can do the experiments in silico that we don't want to do in vivo until we're sure that it's okay.